Hi, welcome. I'm Helmut Licht. Thank you for joining me for this 15th video in a series of videos entitled My God, Here, There, Everywhere. Please remember that my reasoning is based on the following five statements. Good and bad. The head of a criminal organization orders one of its men to rob a bank. The man succeeds, and when he returns with $50,000 in stolen money, his boss says, "Very good," whereas the president of the bank exclaims, "Very bad." While having a casual conversation with your minister, you mention that you never killed anybody. Your minister responds with, "Very good." You watch a news program where a flying ace receives the Congressional Medal of Honor for having shot down a certain number of enemy planes. And with the planes, I'm sure, the members of the respective flight crews. The medal he receives is another form of saying, "Very good." From the perspective of the deceased enemy crew's family members, his heroic action would most certainly be considered bad. What then is good and what is bad? As these are man-made concepts, they are also subject to man's values. What is good for one person is not necessarily good for another. So how can we determine what is good and what is bad? Even our own estimation of good and bad can be reversed under a given situation. A farmer may call rain good when it falls on his crops, but should he be on vacation in some other part of the country and it rains, he may not think of rain as being good. Suppose you are a swim coach and see a child swimming across a pool in terrible form. You might say to yourself that the child is a bad swimmer. If later you discover that the child is extremely crippled, you would probably change your verdict from bad to good, if not excellent. Ergo, before we call something good or bad, we must dig a little deeper. First of all, good and bad are judgments, and therefore have nothing to do with my God, who cannot and does not judge. Good and bad are a product of and subject to time and change. As mentioned earlier, it may be good for a soldier to kill during a war, but bad if he commits the same act during peace. How often has an event in life which you classified as bad at the time it occurred turned out to be a blessing in disguise? There seem to be several ways to judge an event or act. One way might be from the past, the present, and the future. The past would include causes, motives, forces, etc. The present would include present circumstances and situations involving and involved by the act or event. The future would consider consequences and effects. Even from these perspectives, the same person event may appear under different lights. For instance, a man may use his last savings to play the lottery instead of buying groceries for his family. As he has been a compulsive gambler in the past, and as his family could be eating food bought with the money, but is starving because of his gambling present, his act may be classified as bad. Should he win a large amount of money and then improve his and his family's lot future, his act might be classified as good. As all events are contained within my God as eternal truths, and as my God is beyond the time change concept of good and bad, at their root, events or circumstances are neither good nor bad, nor in between. They simply are, and we experience them as our consciousness becomes aware of them, at which point they become subject to our time change consciousness intelligence, which immediately classifies them. Think of good and bad as two colors, for instance, yellow and red, which when united produce a third color, orange. Orange is a color of its own, but has within it red and yellow. If red would be bad and yellow good, what quality would orange be? It seems we do not have a word in our vocabulary which would express a quality which is a combination of good and bad. We don't even have a quality like that, but it must exist. Since we arrive at orange by combining yellow and red, why don't we just mix the letters of good and bad and make a new word which has good and bad in it? Bokadot. Bokadot describes that quality which contains both good and bad. Bokadot is an eternal, timeless truth within my God. This line represents Bokadot, stretching from one end of infinity to the other. Let us now place the dot onto this line. The dot represents a consciousness, such as a human being. Now the infinitely long line is separated into two parts, one reaching into infinity above the dot, the other one below. Bokadot has been brought into the time change dimension. It has been broken down into its two elements, good and bad, and everything below the dot is some degree of bad, everything above it some degree of good. The same can be done with all the other pairs of opposites. Let's give a name to that which is the sum of a pair of opposites. Since it is the opposite of separate, we simply call it a blend. Bokadot is a blend of good and bad. The blend of yellow and red is orange. Here is a small list of blends just to give you an idea. Hofalete, a blend of love and hate. Choldot, cold, hot. Lepomfelti, full, empty. Chuppiroor, rich, poor. Lorkshant, short, long. Verana, far, near, etc., etc. You caused a pair of opposites to come into existence. Without you, without man, without intelligence and consciousness, there would be no opposites. There would only be blends, and the blends blend together to form new blends, and so forth, until all is blended into the ultimate blend, my God. When a consciousness separates, for instance, the blend Bokadot into good and bad, it is done so according to the value system of that particular consciousness. If two consciousnesses are dealing with the same blend, what constitutes good for one may be bad for the other. As can be seen from this illustration, rain would be in the farmer's good area above his dot, but in the vacationer's bad area below the dot. Too much rain would be unfortunate for both and would therefore fall below the point representing the farmer. There are definite blends and indefinite ones. Lepomfelti, which is full empty, is a definite one because one can determine exactly when an 8-ounce glass is full and when it is empty. If it contains 8 ounces of water, it is full. If there is no water in it at all and nothing else, then it is empty. An indefinite blend is Chuppiroor, rich, poor, because rich to one person does not necessarily mean rich to another. Anything or anyone separating a blend, I call a separator. Man is a separator and is therefore always between pairs of opposites and has them also within. Both ends of a blend reach into infinity, and the separator can move along the blend into either direction. Let us for a moment consider the blend Cheldot, cold hot. There is something called a comfort zone, which for our latitude, 40 north, lies between 72 and 76 degrees. Baltimore is situated on that latitude. This means that for the average Baltimorean, a room temperature between 72 and 76 degrees would feel comfortable. To an Eskimo, 74 degrees would be hot, and to a person who has been living near the equator, the same temperature would be cold. In the summer, a wife may use the heating blanket while her husband turns on the air conditioner, because her comfort zone might lie about 10 degrees above his. Though there is no 4-degree comfort zone applicable to all of mankind, we can say that all comfort zones would lie between approximately 50 and 110 degrees Fahrenheit. Thus, this would be mankind's comfort zone. If there's a mankind comfort zone on the shell dot, hot cold blend, then there must be one on all the other blends. With this in mind, let us consider the blend Bogadoj, good and bad. This line represents Bogadoj. Here, Bogadoj has been separated by intelligence, the dot, into good above the dot and bad below the dot. Now intelligence feels comfortable because he can say, good is all that lies above the dot, me, and bad is all that lies below. The line Bogadoj stretches into infinity both below the dot and above the dot. Our comprehension of what lies above us along the good line and below us along the bad line is limited, as shown by the circle. We can only imagine a certain amount of goodness or badness, just as our senses are limited and allow us to only see, hear, touch, and smell that which lies within their reach. We are at the center of all our sensing, saying to ourselves, I see the tree in front of me, I hear the car behind me, etc. We are also the dividing point which determines what is good and what is bad. Now let's increase the good side and decrease the bad side, which means that the respective intelligence, consciousness, human being, strives more and more to become what he, she considers good, and stays more and more away from what he or she thinks is bad. Here we have mostly good and very little bad. Let's proceed a little further to a hypothetical point where the consciousness is being only good. In that case, the dot which divides Bogadoj into good and bad would be touching the bottom of the circle. Here, intelligence is only aware of good, which is impossible. Bogadoj is no longer divided into good and bad. The dot can never leave the circle, for it would mean that the respective intelligence has stopped functioning in a normal way. For the intelligence to stay well, the dot has to be kept there within the circle of its consciousness, which means there has to be a comparative awareness of good and bad. This awareness of good and bad should cause the consciousness to strive toward the good and away from the bad. Before you go, I would like to show you a few pieces of my art. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Thank you for your interest, and I will see you in my next video. Have a wonderful day.